Okay, just setting up the final things before we begin. Later. I am pretty certain that I will need it. Sound actually has
stars.
This is the moment she's a little behind everybody else. Because I can focus on Lan later. I rather I wouldn't have to worry about Lan. Of EP, so it should be fine. Also, I would do algal farming, but it's rather time consuming. But now that I'm on stream, I think I'm fine with treating my algos for it. I found out it's possible, but it is a little annoying. I will need perfection algos, anyways. So, maybe it's not a bad idea? Either way, Metaclus I feel like it's gonna be a little bit of restriction. Dropping. Let's fix this anyhow. Why is Streamlabs eating so much RAM? Sense to fragment farm for them. No, it doesn't. I don't know if I want to finish off Fresno. I don't think there's a point in me waiting. It's like the few fragments that I get from basic search is probably going to be too few and far between. Not to mention she's a two-star, so it's even less likely that it gets specifically her. Mike facing the quick direction.
Voice check.
Hello? Hey. I don't like the way my voice sounds right now. It doesn't feel right. Hello, my name is Nezumi. The more I try to do voice checks, the more I feel like my voice sort of tune. It's hard to describe the feeling. How far can I go in Copley? $35? $36K. I kinda wanna wait until I'm around 40k power for mag stuff. Can I check the power level? Can. Okay, the first wall is a black hole 40. I think I should try it. So let's start with black hole and probably go to Copley and then mag. Oh, it starts off real simple. Well, I should probably bring Oni. Do I have a specific team I could use? What this one is for?
Yanni,
junbi totonoimashita.
Okay. I should probably do algo tuning now so I don't have to leave later. So stuck. I have no good reflection one pieces. It's likely for later. Limit value. Anything? Physical pen. Okay. Amazing offering defense. Anything super useful. Oh, that's not bad, actually. Oops, limit value 2. was crit damage. I think I'll keep it. I don't think I need crit damage as much. That's acceptable. That looks not bad. Okay, now I'm okay to go. I doubt I can beat Wisdom without a healer, but I will try. I don't know why I'm thinking about positioning. I'll take a moment before we actually get to anything higher. Approximately 40 levels, in fact. Yeah, it's two. Oh, okay. Just for record's sake, I should probably check this. Not listed. Cool. Damage I took, I'm a little skeptical of my chances. What two guards even work? Oh, it's Octogen. Algo farming if I can tune my algos a little bit. Though still, in my opinion, it would be rather boring to just watch me try to micro my way through algo farming for like half an hour? 2 hours? I feel like a good amount of time. I would probably have to do it off stream though, because Wednesday I have to be doing a lot of farming due to reflection being very useful to me. However, at the same time, exploit and resolve I don't think are that useful to me, oddly enough. I mean, I could always use resolve on somebody else. I don't think anyone can use exploit. Actually, Emotep maybe. Because Emotep is a possible healer, but... yeah. So maybe it isn't so bad. Though I need to do farming area 1 for Lamb and also Fresno, who will prefer Paradigm. So I think I'd rather do area 1. Oh, Tatsu! Oh! Okay. How do you pronounce those names? The name of Souls of Swords? Now then, so many of these levels are the same. They're just different variants. Stronger mobs are slightly different mobs, like Fortitude instead of one of these protector guys. Something else like that. I have to plan. What can my micro possibly be? Maybe even just one tap wisdom? But at the same time, getting everyone to target wisdom sounds like a problem. Because I imagine all the snipers will too run the same. Surely there's an allure reason why Hubble is in here. Also, these rewards I would imagine would stack up to something. It's supposedly 39 block hole stages after all. Neural kits are very useful. At the moment, you don't really have a way to get many neural kits. You can also use them for fragment farming. Or armor quartz. I think I'll use the armor quartz for much. Yeah, I can use them for fern, but I don't really think I'm going to be able to fern. And most of the other dolls are currently unavailable to me. So many key cards. Maybe I do just spend a while finding Reflect. Because there are a lot of Reflect pieces. What do you mean? There's also the possibility that I farm Reflect for other people other than Xion. Also, I might need different or more Reflect pieces than usual, because I'm not exactly sure if I can go through this Reflect or if each should be better. About it though. Because I'm not building very many dolls, the refreshes I do are probably going to be pretty impactful. Because one day I'm basically only farming for Fresno, Tuesday it's Lam and Chanzu, Wednesday it's Xion. Empty tile? It's not empty? Fine. Oh, it's gonna work. $4 at a shoe card. 25. Earn and something. And it seems not bad so far. Plus I'm sat checking in. Start becoming a threat because we're 25 out of presumably 39. I mean, I'm definitely gonna try 40. I don't know how well it's gonna go. Maybe that's just gonna happen. Seven. These are taking like less than a minute. Oh, I need to switch my voice to more. 28. I don't know why I put Yen in the tile. I wanted to pull the splasher. But I pulled the draft tile, I suppose. Ready? It sounds like awesome. 30. Evelyn, Angela, Sophia. How many key cards do I have in storage? How many am I away? I'm wondering if it's gonna be more efficient to target down wisdom? Actually, it probably is. I can't live extension to poverty. And I guess another question is, where do I put everybody? For the longer fight. There's no way I can just run two guards. Lord of the healing. Oh, not the healing. I mean, that's Lord of the healing. But not the sustain. No sustain sounds like a huge issue. Another awesome fight. I've done an up nitrogen. I didn't even, like, Python is not in any of the later ones, is it? I wonder if there's a reason why they chose all these dolls. Resources far better than a new plane, so I'm hoping that can also carry me a little bit of that exploring. Because his land is way stronger than what most characters should be at this stage of the game. Fresno? Kind of as well. Okay, we're getting close. 38. Thirty-nine. Oh, this is very bad. Did land this occur? Should be fine. Yeah, definitely okay. Staying at the purge is definitely a good idea. I have them like this. There's a very high likelihood they just get pierced through. I think I'll try waiting for wisdom to go last first. Let's try to target this guy as well. I don't think Lem auto scales very useful here. Distinction with depravity. Try to burst your gun. Actually kind of close. Okay, I forgot to pause and listen. Huh. land mold that I possibly could have done it. And rubber battery. Everything wisdom is somewhat of a waste. We push you down. Oh, easy. I don't think that stage needs a tutorial. Does it? Cleared. 20 more stages to go until the next wall. I'm kind of curious how hard it is. Oh, I'm at 10 times speed. I was wondering why things are so slow. Why? Did I see that red? Stack this extra damage to the pylons? If so, that's really funny and also extremely useless information. I have a flag for the mercy of test. Wait, it does! That's really funny. But it's still a little niche bit of information. Okay, let me save that. That's so silly. 33 minutes. Stop or tap some ellipses. Tons. I swear, some of these levels are gonna be harder than actual stages. These things are pushers. Oxygen. Phew. I could not find the buttons. Imagine if I failed right then and there. I think I should start going on one time from now on. That seems bad. Take a device. Oh, zombie included is not good. It might be better. Uh, say, Fezza won't be in a bad spot. She's the only one who marked with Banksy, so Banksy's been tagging her. This should hit Mercy. I didn't expect it to floor Mercy, though. I'll wait for this. Goodbye. Okay. This should hit him. Oh, dodge. There you go. I'll just put a time stamp on that in case I wanted to clip myself being stupid. We have 14 more stages until the next wall. Officially, I don't expect myself to pass. What's it called? Data, I guess? Would actually be really helpful. Wait, is that auto to go through? Why not? I might have targeted the wrong thing with Yanni. Oh, well, things are with me on. I do have like 40 of the configs. However, I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to use them. I don't think there's any dolls that use duplicate alphas at the moment. It's not like I'm in a tough impasse with a very optimal team, but a good algo would likely be fixing. Huh. It's really fun to watch the presence of a moonshot using this stuff. That's in the totem. That increase of skill haste is really nice. Okay, 49, so how many more do I need? 11. Yeah, the enemies are starting to get beefier. Oh, but it's really interesting seeing this. I'm actually... Uh-oh. Lock on fire. I should double check if there's any, fragments that I should be buying. And Aki. Let's pull out of the hover. Well, that didn't do much. Aki is a huge GPS threat. Let's take care of him first. Okay. sustenance for a pretty decent amount. Oh, this one. Oh my god. So goodbye, I guess. It definitely looks so unfair to watch Lam just absolutely floor somebody with, what, 17,000 damage? I'm starting to... Oh, never mind. This isn't the greatest user of this, but it's fine. Yes, I think it's fine. Uh-oh. Okay, Lam's got it. Ah, nice job, Lam. Doing more than the other two carriers combined. Jellyfish is flanking. Did nothing. Okay, cool. I mean, this is Yanny. What did it do? 700 damage? 10% of damage reflected? So she blocked 7,000 damage? That's not bad. I guess. Oops, I took that. Why do I even click off of the screen? It's full screen! Actually, barely not. Have you ever noticed that a single pixel? Seeing how the guards are struggling now, I doubt 60 is possible. However, I at least want to get there. There's no red in that health bar anymore. Anywho, this cutoff texture is a projectile from them. And this is the frame, right before it dies. Come on! Onto the laser. 55. Then, 70 florins. Maybe I should target Mercy first. Oh, Yenny's got interrupted. Oh my gosh! That charm did a lot of damage. You got unhorny. Horny no more. You get a laser. I wonder... No. I was wondering if I can afford a costume. I mean, I know I can. This is gonna take a while. It's actually kind of scary. I'm spreading out the damage a little too much. And laser. Oh, she missed it. Or rather, I missed, but she missed it. I'm not really sure what to do in this position. It's the pleasure just going. Let's kill the moderation. Currently trying to mine the tower with a shovel. I don't know if it's winning when it dodges one of her attacks. I don't even know those towers have any dodge rate. Also, my voice giving. It's not exactly cracking, but it can feel it, like fade. A little shame. That's a pretty far amount of damage in there. As long as the lamb doesn't take too much more damage, we're fine. Fresnel's got it. Hey Fresnel, do what you do best. Uh-oh. Oh, it's the one before. I'm actually way below the recommended power now. I'm not exactly sure. Actually, who is my last team member? Because, oh, speaking of. I should finish doing my neural switches. Oh, it's Jin. Hello. I don't exactly imagine. To get anything in this one of searches, but I'm still going to try. Or not.
Neural crowd!
Just crashed. Hopefully I didn't get anything cool. I didn't get a doll at least. I'm not exactly sure what I got though. It's gonna be impossible to tell. Actually say the odds. I know it's rather low though. That's not good. Okay. So how many of these we have in storage? Holy. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. That's a lot of keys. I could use them in reflection algos. Oh, I'll need a lot of stack algos. I suppose I should start with this. I have a lot of keys to grind through. Let's retype this. Grinding a lot of keys on algorithms. Takes a really long time for it to type it out. There we go. Like I typed that like 30 seconds ago. Farming is pretty precise. I need to make sure to enable that. And afterwards, I need to make sure Chansey gets a teleport. Or I time it so Chansey can dodge the teleport. But dodge the patience blade. I'm not exactly sure what happened, but I know what happened was really bad. Is this currently not really way for me to survive extinction of gravity? Hey, gosh. A good bait. Wednesday 2. SMV 3. Upper end defense. One block offensive. Key defense blue post battle region. Why is it so much harder when it climbs to your speed further? Like, I feel like I have less time. Maybe I can spam people. Because I can't cancel the ability. Oh my gosh. When I can live that thing, it'll be so much easier. There's no point in me farming Momo Wednesday algas either. You know what? I could save myself a headache and just use all these on Thursday. Second thought. I should probably at least get through the... What was it? I should at least get through my, like, daily refreshes. the drastic differences in HP. I'm gonna need a teleporter at some point. What damaged her? Because the answer I teleported her, she took damage from something. I'm sure I need Chansey's all. I might need to use a Timmy on. Ah, nice. Wednesday 2. Offense, physical pen, white, HP. Offense. Flat attack, blue, HP. Should I take Copley? Copley or... Max toy first. After I do this extremely time between the process of algo farming. She has 21,000. This is fine. How much is in crit again? And I mistimed that a lot.
Oh,
this before. That was a very clean auto cancel. Nice. Let's see. Two reflection. Two flat physical defense. Reaction 2, physical defense percent. Don't have a Kanzi. Cool. Why is that a little, like, any little bits of damage would actually make this so much more efficient? Like, we just need a tiny bit more damage on the Kanzi. They're like, maybe I should be running reflect instead. They wait for the damage. Good enough. Okay. I could barely see Wisdom's auto attack through that. It was so much faster to just enter the data that time. Damage. I don't think she has anything, does she? Replace it with this one. I really need post battle regen at the moment. So maybe I just focus on getting rid of this. Oh, there's some really nice one blocks here. Actually, maybe I can build a good exploit. A little bit more attack. This could work. Also, I don't know who I'd want perception on.
So, glass lens の調整完了.
I could just use it as a filler thing. Hopefully this is some backslash. Wait, what am I doing? I missed the first arena. Why do they all have a green icon on them? I can't recall these, but it feels like cheating. Don't crit. Stop critting. Come on, Fresno, go! I think she should be fine. Just to be s- oh, I can turn it out safer. Okay. Oh, it's like she has her passive. She should be okay. One save, two corruption, two off defense percent. A healing.
Yeah.
can upgrade? Small amount of hatchery. I really want the defense. I want the crit one eventually. And now this tiny bit, tiny bit more hashery, maybe. Maybe it'll make these a tiny bit easier. That was close. Hold tight. You good? Reduce Annie's tankiness. Okay. Shouldn't be fine. Onesie, two progression, 2%. One block special. Up defense, white, physical pen. Could do more refreshes, but oh my gosh. It's so painful and time-consuming. Can't imagine I'll get much stronger. Let's try this. Wait, I have 28 skill. Huh. I'm probably Chanzi next. I just need a lot of pivots now. Should do 2 without anything, then 2 with like one super buff soul, and the other one with snipers. Is it probably could spend one doing like a mental cage coordinated crit? Sure about Bunny. Holy damage. If I do a coordinated crit one now, What if you pull on diligence? Look at that position! I've never shown before. You kill the thrower? Nice! Efficient. What is Sion yelling? Oh, did you crit or something? Okay, let's do one with a super buff soul. That's so much damage. He's targeting the Xion now. Good. Maybe like this? Maybe not. That's so much damage. Oh, maybe I stun tornado. Maybe heal a bit? No. I think Stun Tornado is the way. Okay, maybe instead I bring the guard functions. I need to find a place to use more functions though. After every auto attack now. Holy. She used her skill more than her auto attacks. Almost twice as much. It's love in mint, not mind. That looks silly now. Why is Chansey taking? Why is Chansey taking so much damage? That's so interesting. So parried something. anything more, the blaze seems to work. Now that I just fought the stage. I wonder if I should be playing on this for myself. Is that actually here? But there's more. Oh, because I miscounted, which is really bad. Has to be the last fight. Oh my God. I think I have a filler team going first. Second team is these four plus somebody else. I think freezing bullets is... yeah, I don't need it. So if I tell, like, if I can clear with this, that'd be pretty useful. The plan is to hook Mercy. We just target Mercy. Diligence does a lot. Also, it seems everyone gets melted. Oh, there's no need for me to have Yanni do anything. I probably shouldn't have Yanni pull anything. Wow, that's confusing. Man, soul damage is rather sad. Then maybe I should target in the dog instead. Maybe I start with the other team first. Maybe I have the second TB hash snipers. It's gonna be physical? Freezing bullets, but I'm not exactly big problem is that maybe I see the teams in reverse. The Fez will go first and try to clear out the mobs. Maybe. Structural makes more sense on Fresno. Even though I can trigger on other people. Because other mobs melt pretty quickly. Actually not that bad. I do think I should be sacking Mai though. Just for extra stats. This maybe. Maybe not the Shanda first. In a pretty good position. It seems not bad until Chang is one shot. Simple so well. The mercy seems to kill pretty quickly. Oops. Oh, is there anything you could change? I don't think so. Maybe I could just go pony back. Much the other team needs a medic though. Lem is half HP. But I don't know how Yanni could have done that. Isn't worth it. Wait, we should do this. This bonus is a lot of damage. I think Fresnel's aim to stop getting thrown up by Ucharis. Good enough. What? She's gonna stall, but this is probably the best chance I got of beating him. It will. It's definitely taking effort.
Ready?
Get him, buddy. Coordinated crit for sure. This for sure. This one. I bet he's hitting the rock. They're breaking a shield in time. Ah, now seems like a good time. This seems a lot less possible than I thought. Solid doesn't do that much. Oh, maybe we should bring Desperate Sword instead of Vitality Loss. Oh, buddy. Possibility. Ooh, perfectly timed. Still hitting a rock. Soul survived for this long, but that's cool. Whoa, what are they reaggro? I had it! But I had a glitch where I couldn't hold to the land. She's so sad. I mean, that's pretty good for Desperate Assault, at least. Mediocre damage. So close. No, there's no way this works. That's still so low. There's no way this does 123,000 damage. Built more of the dolls, it would be more possible. Ooh! I can use those pivots. I think we should do lambs first. Actually, use 2 and 3. Use 1 and 3. Keep it. It's better than nothing. I think the more of what I'm doing will be easier. Anywho, to Copley. Okay, we left off here. The thing triplets are affected when we attack the higher order and triplet in the center. This tactic is effective. Looks like this strategy is effective on the triplets we countered so far. That's great. Can you cover me? I'll assault him. Leave it to us! I can't tell if that's business Antonia or like normal Antonia. As the last entropic dies, the liquid entropy in Hugh's tide fully recedes. The doll pulls her lens out of the entropic hive and returns to her side. Battle is over. Perfect and efficient. It's hard to believe that you only just started finding these things after coming here. I'll simply use my abilities to my advantage. Okay. There's too many, like, super low voice characters. I simply use my abilities to my advantage. The professor's directions were very helpful. I might not even be a match for you in a one-on-one battle above ground. So humble. Well, neither as if you're a tactical doll to begin with. So we're the same in that aspect. Are you saying the professor's more efficient if you're recommending tactical dolls? Perhaps the professor might have had a relevant experience, no? You here have conquered many lands far and wide by being an army of tactical dolls. Oh, never mind. I knew you wouldn't give a serious answer to that. Very humorous of you, Professor. If you got the call... Well, it's called as humorous. You'll see utilizing the word as a synonym for asking for a beating. Perhaps that method of lightening the mood was not quite appropriate. Just then, as if sensing my gaze, she turns to meet my eye. Hello. Hello, Professor. I believe it's the first time we met. I am Ohatsu Cherry. She extends a hand towards me. However, our hands only touch for a brief moment before she lets go and melts us. So, what are you doing here? My companions, Sword Boy, signaled vanished you. I came to look for him. I didn't expect you to run to others in a place like this. You know what's going on here? As you can see, Professor, the bedrock up here is no hindrance to me. Fortunately, I have not been investigating this place for too long. When it comes to an ambition deeper within, I might not know as much as you do. Wanna work together? You want me to travel with you, Professor? Given the present situation, I shall be able to travel with you for a while. Well, not just for a while. We've established a base in the section called the Oasis. If you're willing, you can join us. That is a great suggestion. But right now, I simply need to find Suyui first. Suyui? I don't know how to pronounce his name. I will not have the luxury of contemplating other matters until this vital task is completed. Understood. I'm glad you understand, Professor. Now then, let us get along the journey that is to come. Well, since we're temporary allies, let's share what we know. Alright, now uploading synchronized information. Upload complete. Have you learned anything new? Good news! Anything that the Cherry gave us is useful. We can basically confirm the existence of a tree-shaped network among entropic units. They're different from the ones we encountered in Pyridus, not just in their source code, but also in their command structure. The entropics in the Copley sector know how to fight in unison, with high-order entities issuing commands with lower ranks. I see. No one of the other individuals are temporarily incapacitated when we take down the higher-order entropics. I guess it's because they need some time for another higher-order entropic to take command over them. If they can afford to, we should focus far on these hive leaders. That should make the remainder easier to deal with. That sounds like very useful information. Sounds good. There's good news. What about the bad? The bad news is this is the fifth entropic hive we destroyed. The deeper we go, the more of these mini hives we encounter. If the number of these hives increases with every step, it's going to slow down our exploration speed. That doesn't sound too bad. Is it a signal you're tracking deeper within? Yes, we need to go much deeper. Why is everyone here supposedly this super, like, relaxed voice? Have you found any traces of soil? That's a chair shakes your head. I haven't been able to pick up other dull signals either. Have you considered that Swayo might not be here? The last time we detected Swayo's signal, it was in the Copley sector. Also, the comms on the surface were perfectly functional. So if there is anywhere we wouldn't be able to get a signal, it would have to be underground. What if you can find him down here? He's here. I'm sure of it. Is he very important to you? He is my companion, and also the other, only other doll of the same model as me. So I make you brother and sister. Brother and sister? Why do you say that? In human terms, a pair of individuals created by the same person would be called siblings. I see. I guess that would be the case. Swayo is my younger brother, the common among, so I must find him. Well, I don't understand the concept of siblings. I'm not going to stop here if that's a risk, if that's where you're taking this. But before that, I want to record the environmental changes in this area. What's wrong? Persicaria appears and walks over towards Antonina. You should take a look for yourself. It seems you aren't the first visitors to this place. What are you looking at? Atsuchiri, use your weapon to lift an object wrapped in goop from inside the liquid entropy and show it to me. There's a damper here that's been chewed up. Looks like it was left behind by a resident agent from a certain sector. You're in the first batch of agents who have come this way, Professor. And the agents who came before us were probably devoured by those monsters. Atsuchiri lowers the damper into a pool of water and swirls it around a little to wash off the liquid entropy and puts it away. What's wrong with the damper? Nothing that I could see. It's just that when we return to the surface, I can return it to the administrator. Perhaps the administrator is worried about the appearance of this agent. Or perhaps she already knows about all this. After all, there's no way that the sector administrator wouldn't know what's going on within our sector. Perhaps. But this is a work habit of mine. You seem very calm. Not worried about Swayo? Swayo isn't weak. I'm sure he wouldn't have been devoured so easily by monsters like these. I must not let my agitation jeopardize my chance of finding him. However, Atsuchiri presses her lips. Her expression does not seem to be as calm as her tone suggests. Professor, I'd like to move forward ASAP. What do you plan to do? We can go. Then I'll continue scouting underground like usual, like before. I'll contact you if I pick up anything unusual. With that, she sinks underground. As we proceed further into the cave, I hear a strange sound. It is a rhythmic tremor. Initially, it is faint, but as we head toward the location indicated by Antonina, it becomes louder and louder, pounding on my eardrums like the rhythm of a heartbeat. I look to Antonina beside me. She's gripping the edges of her terminal tightly, and her eyes stare into the distance, into the unknown darkness. Antonina, the view. A drastic reaction. It's nothing. I was just filtering out the noise when the signal returns. Why did you call out to me all of a sudden? Did you hear something that sounded like a heartbeat? I did. And it didn't just sound either. She indicates the ground beneath her feet. The The hard gray rock is covered in bulges and grooves of varying thicknesses, crisscrossing over each other in a way that looks like plant roots and blood vessels on an organ surface. The rock is covered with these things, and the texture is similar to rock, yet slightly different. It's like we're walking through some sort of life forms, nervous systems. The similar reaction is also growing stronger. Just how strong is it gonna get? Are you scared? Very funny. I'm approaching the entropics, but I'd be scared. His face is great bravado, yet her tone betrays her uncertainty. Agarese is a world of data, so why is the sound of a heartbeat here? Makes me feel very uncomfortable. Ooh, nodes you're talking about it exist underground as well, but they are not quite the same as you described. They're underground too? Can you bring up a section for us to look at? I'll try. A few seconds later, Hot's chair emerges from the ground, and a hole closes up behind her. They're not made of rock. They look like parts of some agent. They cut off a piece here. This is the entropic code structure. They're still animate, non-individuals, more like part of a living creature. The ones on the surface have already hardened. Are the parts on the ground still active? Is that so? I can't tell. Only that they can't be part of like the bedrock. Does it affect your movements while you're underground? A little, but it doesn't really matter. I've encountered similar root systems while I worked underground before. All I have to do is cut them up. Can you analyze the signal they carry? I can try. Several seconds later, a soft, garbled sound emerges from Antonina's terminal. At first, it's just indistinct moaning, like a freshly born beast. As Antonia raises the audio resolution, it gradually turns into something like a woman's voice. You can hardly call it a language, yet it clearly conveys emotion, anger, sorrow, intense desire. Like a heart howling because it can't wait to break free of the ribcage incarcerating it. Antonina presses the stop button. That's what it contains? Just then, the ground suddenly trembles again. The tentacle-like grippings of the ground begin to shudder, and the small chunks of upland fall from the cavern roof into the pools of water. Another earthquake? No. It looks like the bedrock is shaking. What's happening? The signal radius is growing. The bearer signal jamming is gone. Persicaria, do you read? The tremor suddenly stops. A tinnitus call echoes through the cavern, and the light of the transmitter has gone dim once more. Did the signal cut out again? Yeah, it did. Thanks to the abnormality in the barrier, I managed to scan further. This time, I managed to precisely pinpoint the location. Not only that, I know the exact disposition of the enemy forces. Are there any dull signals in the position of the higher order chamber? At the position of that high order entropic? Sadly not. Perhaps the opposition has a counter-jamming system because I picked up the noise of the signal. Noise? What kind of noise? I'll play it for you. This is an encrypted message from Soya. He's trapped somewhere nearby and is calling for help. It's an encrypted message. I can't believe they're encrypted messages that I don't know about. No, I didn't even realize this was a form of encryption. When was this developed? It's a special ability of our model. It's used to transmit messages underground. Normal systems simply dismiss it as noise when they pick it up. Soya wouldn't use it under normal circumstances. The fact that he's using it means the situation must be very severe. I'm sorry, Professor, but we'll need to part ways from here. I must go. Well, I won't stop you from saving your friend, but the signal I've been tracking is extremely strong. It'll be very dangerous if you go alone. That's alright. I'm showing an Insuayo in terms of fighting ability and functional performance. I want to save him Pisa. Every second counts. If I make you hurry along with me, you might face greater danger. I understand. Good luck. Wait a minute. What's the signal source is with Suayua? You mean the Hayato and Tropic that might have captured Suayua? Now that you mention it, judging by their approximate locations, that is quite likely. We can only pick up a signal at this distance with Antonio's help, but that he managed to pinpoint his exact location. And if our targets are in the same place, we can still part ways then. Indeed. You have a point, Professor. However, rescuing him is still my top priority. Once I verify he is not with your target, then we will go our separate ways. Here's the jolly cooperation, then. As you're clearing away the Entropics blocking your path, your vision suddenly lights up. The rock here is riddled with holes by a purplish black liquid operands. The wind makes a high-pitched and mournful noise as it blows through the vine holes in the rock. She, the high-order Entropic you're looking for? In the faint purple light, I see a massive figure perched on a rock. Her upper body looks like just like any other agent's. The massive tentacles protrude from the tumorous growth that is her lower body. Twitching and sensing the conditions of their surrounding, it seems she has noticed us. But she starts to struggle, as if trying to shake free of something. Your ear-piercing shriek fills the underground cavern. All the operands in the area are gathered within her. There's no doubt about it, she's the sword of the signal. Looks like there really is a virus. I told you it was real. I forgot what she sounds like. But didn't you call a sanctifier over? Why did a virus-infected creature come over instead? Don't know. Maybe the sanctifier's got infected. You don't say. In any case, this proves that there's a virus in Copley Sector, right? So will you help us investigate the entropic now, Miss Carter? It's a pain. It's your job as an administrator. Fine. Whichever you do. I just realized the subtitles are perfectly covering her. Bikini? It seems a little small for a bikini. Your sector administrative permissions to help us find the owner of this feather. The cigar hands the feather O'Donnell dropped in Tarn. Fine. Not too far, I hope. Less complaining, more moving. Still drags Tarn with her out of the admin center. The cigar and Delacy slowly fall behind him. Miss Delacy! What's up, Percy? Are you okay? It's the first time fighting those monsters. They're quite a handful, aren't they? Aw, I'm fine. But this is based on my looks. I'm a pretty good fighter, you know. If we have a chance later on, I'll tell you about how I wrestled a brown bear as a roving doll mechanic. If only the professor could be here to hear the story. Hopefully you'll get the chance. Are you sure this way?
Yep.
It feels like we're back at the beach from before. See? That's where we got swept away. Hey, are you seeing anything unusual along the stretch? No. I want to go home. Aww. Will you be serious about this? Any further food and you'll end up in the sea. If we can't find... You don't even have to come all this way. Maybe the person you're looking for would be Serpent's Nom in the first place. Also, that look on her face is amazing. But we didn't see her back then. She looks half human, half entropic. I'd recognize her even if she turned into ash. Suddenly, Tarnum's tent is up as if she noticed something. Hey, what am I gonna name for? What's behind me? Tarnum doesn't answer. Instead, she pulls herself around from Soul's grip and starts running toward the sea. Hey! Hey! What the heck are you doing? Got you! Soul catches up to Tarnum and beats the ever loving shit out of him. Oh, be gentle. I'll be gentle when you stop pulling stunts like that. I'll talk. What did you run off? Need to hurry. Hurry? For what? Need to hurry. Need to hurry. Oh, she's stronger than she looks. What's going on? Persicaria? Hang on, so. It's transmission from Antonina. We got through just for a second. Really? What did she say? I didn't say anything. The signal cut off before she could speak. All I heard was some noise, as well as something that sounded like a heartbeat. What are you saying, Persicaria? Why would there be a heartbeat on the cloud server? I don't know. I'm more concerned about how the comms were destroyed temporarily. Maybe... is an underground entrance nearby? The signal got better? I experienced something like that in the past when I was working underground with my friends. You really can do anything, Deli. In that case, should we head closer to the sea? Maybe we'll be able to contact the professor and the others again. Hang on, Persicaria. We'll get to work whenever the professor's name comes up. I know what you're thinking. That something must have happened on the ground and the comms just suddenly restored. But our priority right now is to find Odaya. If she's hiding nearby, she can ambush us at any time. No, it's too late. Tarnum, who has been struggling against Soul's arms all this time, suddenly stops and stares dumbly at the sea. Too late? What are you talking about? She's here. Wait, do you mean? Before Soul can finish, she senses the gaze on her back. Practically by instinct, she ducks to the side. Black claws whistle past her ears. Ha! Then, riding her momentum, she does a flip and lands a kick on the attacking black shadow. Not expecting the blow, the figure sent flying several meters away. Sally, she looks so weird when she's reversed. I'm fine, just take care of the administrator. Ew, look at her hand. Sal draws her twin blades and plants herself between the shadow and the others. After being kicked into the shallow waters, the ambusher slowly rises and reveals the true identity. A dial. The dark purple in the former administrator of the art sector seems deeper than before, and the traces of her bestial metamorphosis are more obvious too. Seawater and cloudy entropy mix together and drips off the strands of her hair. This is... Lux One. This individual doesn't look like a sanctifier we saw before. Do you know her, Sally? Yeah, she's a sanctifier from the second administrator. We have... a history. Just as Soul is about to face off with Odile, Odile waves her hand. Several low-order and tropical individuals then crawl out of the sea, banging their claws and fangs as they approach. So that's what you were hiding. Are you cowards or what? Since you showed up, let's have a good clean fight. Odile ignores Soul. She spreads her black wings and feet, and her feet slowly lift off the ground. Oh, no you don't. Soul tries to run up and intercept her dive, but the untripped creature is already charging at her, forcing her to hack away at its attacking tentacles with a swing of her blade. When she looks again, Odile's already flown over everyone's heads, heading for the land. More rustling comes from behind him. Fear-pushed and trumpet individuals lying in ambush within the shadows emerge en masse, leaving Sol too busy to worry about anything else. The Sakaar and the Lazy take up fighting things too. Sai! They're coming to help you! I'm leaving this over to you, Deli. He's trying to use them to buy us of time. Don't let her get away! Persicaria, I need shield support. Got it. Here we go! Sol slips in the head of a nearby trumpet and uses it to launch herself towards the dial. However, Odile is a bit higher than Sol, and her chop is nothing but air. Boom! Damn it! Oh my gosh, I haven't yelled in a while. Just as she's about to fall, Sol drops her shoulder weapon and launches it with a kick. The blade completes a revolution of the air, and a hilt hits Odile in the abdomen. She immediately starts spiraling unsteadily toward the ground. Got her! We're done over here! Yeah, that should have hurt her. We'll head this way and pursue her. Look out, so! In the quantities of liquid and trouble we found earlier, it's probably on all the forces she brought along. There might be Intrepid's covering with a channel in this path. Yeah, got it. As soon as validated for Sakaria's guests, Intrepid creatures really start emerging from the other side of the path. Piece of cake! Searing! Sol casts the flames on both her swords forward and annihilates the group blocking her path. Okay, if this is... that means I think I'm doomed because I have no way of healing. I think I need to invest in Sol more. I actually kind of need a warrior, and Sol is the most invested warrior I have at the moment. So, I think the all ones are better after some thought. There's only one layer though, so I probably shouldn't have taken this. I should not have got this. Wow, that's a lot of damage. I almost hit the wrong button. Go offensive build because he can kind of heal. Yeah, we need a post-battle region on Zion and Yanni again. Doing this and this are rather important. But I could just use the offensive strategy to take it out. Target the things that are targeting the squishies first. Ocean. Let's look at this thing first. Think she died last. Oh, this one's fun. Oh, that little boy was here. This hurts kind of chaotic. That sucks. Cool. I should not take on the ransom. Do it. I don't think it's worth it, but I'll do it anyways. I don't actually know how they... Oh, that's two waves. Shug. Can't actually afford anything. Unless I want to buy a sharpshooter and then just have no healing. Worth it. It's not these two. Oh, wait. Oh, whatever. Too much chance. It is shadow. Wait, this fight is different. This fight is so different. Oh, it's a time trial. Oh, crap. Oh, I didn't realize it's a time trial. I completely misunderstood what that was meant to be. Oh, I thought I was meant to kill it in that time frame. No, I was just meant to survive. A time of utter modesty. I forgot to... Oh, it's fine. Pretty sure I can fight advanced ones. And I probably should, because I know my team is so weak against this mod. Despite having AoE. Okay. Maybe not. Sure. It's always nice when it's usable. Jeez. I am just one shot in hand. The guard one. I'm not running Saul or anything. Thanks for running. He feels so good with Earth Tiles. actually think this is insanely useful. But I'm pretty sure Chanzi has a weird interaction with it. Does it deal damage 3 times in normal attacks? Wait, that's so interesting. It triggers the... It must work like that for the other functions as well. First time I've seen this. There are two fights I have to do. I do still find it so funny that as they pop up, Blam just shoots up. She's like shooting them in the same place as well. It's amazing. That doesn't seem very useful. Run KLO. And free crit damage. Someone turned the lights off on the beach.
Yanni, 準備整いました. 行動開始だ.
Time for a more normal fight. This one at least is very not bad.
みんなが努力した結果です.
function area. Sure. That's a good one. I'd be a little conscious with my health, but it's not that bad. Yes! Nice. I really don't like mental cage. Ooh. And Kayla. It's really hard to go around with Kayla. She has the opening one and the battery. Her first reset. Okay, organize. So four shots in a row. Like, that's really insane. I don't actually need that. Dang, I have so much money, I should have just bought the other anything. And I can still buy upsurge. Oh my god, I have too much stuff. I probably shouldn't have taken this thing. I'll just rush to the end now. Yeah, she actually just gets four shots in a row. It's so crazy. I don't even know why I'm doing this. I don't need it. Why is the meta so ridiculous? She should be the second last one. There's actually just straight up not enough enemy for the fights to be hard. You learned to kill someone, huh? There's a tower defense on here. Oh, there's a lot of stages. I'm not even like halfway through yet. Ooh, ee, ooh, my tentacles are too hard to handle. I found massive tentacles dash wildly in an area on the high order and trumpet, easily breaking our offensive. If only we could get close. Got it. Mind your front. The front? But the chariot doesn't answer. Instead, she splits his tentacle in front of her, in two with a swing of her spear before leaping to the ground again. The next moment, she appears in front of Antonina. As the chariot appears, tentacles burst the ground behind him. However, on his cone pockets flat almost at the same time as Josie immobilized him. Find new code! Is she casting a magic spell? At the same time, as a cherry spear pierces through the tentacle grappling Anna. As the cherry grabs Anna and instantly switches position with him. It's up to you. It's close enough. And as a target, landing program ready? The massive hydrant Chopi seems to have been sensed something and turns towards us. The ground building up, the ground bolts up and splits open, and a sound of crackling rocks fills our ears. The dull, heavy heartbeat grows more and more intense, and even the ground trembles, like we were stepping on a raw, live heart. Commencing all thread DDoS attack! Helena Trevor puts up no resistance as Antonina pins her to the spot. She tilts her head and looks towards Antonina with confusion. The DDoS. Look out! But the chair rushes forward and grabs Antonina's arm as they let out a warning cry. Both of them roll to the side. A tentacle suddenly erupts in the ground while Antonina is standing. His tip blindly crushed through the air for a bit before disappearing back on the ground. Thank you. Can't believe she could reach so far. No problem. It was to help me with the underground tentacles earlier. Speaking of which, did you just hear what I said? Sawed off from behind, she's becoming more and more familiar with our attack patterns. I mean, she's learning. The speed at which she's growing. We're probably seeing more things that exceed our understanding. In any case, we need to come up with new tactics. If they split up with one group trying to distract her while the other tries to ambush her, they might have a winning shot at this. I understand. If you pin her down on the surface, I'll launch a swift attack by going underground. This sort of close combat is very dangerous. Are you sure you want to do this? Yes. This should be the solution available to us at the moment. I'll be counting on you for cover. She gives a thumbs up and dips under the ocean. It dips on the ground. Also, be right back and use the restroom. moving too fast. Oh, forget it. Let's finish this up quickly. Professor, stay back. Sure. Move further back. I need to make something here that will draw her attention. Green offerings glow around on Serena's body. I'm not sure if it's just my imagination, but the hieroentropic has been staring at Serena the whole time. Entropics. Come. With their garbled words, the number of cracks in the ground starts to grow. This time, what comes through them are not tentacles, but densely packed lesser entropics. Going for the monster horde tactics that you're so good at again! But I'm prepared for this! Lower entropics which have just emerged are immediately bound by Antonina's programs. The first ranks are stuck in the passage, blocking the passage of the entropics behind them. However, they are not sold for long. The entropic trap is officially chewing through their colleagues above them. The binding program soon lose effect, and the monsters rush at us like a tidal surge. Damn, there's too many of them! The Lodo and Tropics are practically fused together into a single being that is surrounded Antonina. Even when their front ranks are destroyed, the new ones fill the gap almost immediately. I continue observing the surrounding, until the moment comes when all the Entropics are grouped up into one place. Now! Orbital Strike! The clusters of Tropics are taken by surprise and reduced to ashes by our combined attacks. Wait, so I can actually use that. Realizing that our attacks aren't working against us, the outer entropic lowers your head and wraps your tentacles around the rock. You slowly slither downward. What direction? She's not coming at us, so where is she going? I click the pastor, which is the slow fade-in. About to cheer me. As the higher entropic looks down, Hachichiri emerges from the rock wall next to her. The high order entropic senses Hachichiri's approach immediately, but the latter's lance is just one step ahead. Ah! Rome, it hurts! Hachichiri's attack pierces through her body, and the high order entropic makes a garbled noise that sounds like a wail. It hurts! Let me go. The tentacle starts dashing wildly. There is a shout. The sound tentacle that begins pounding the roof of the cavern. The entire room starts trembling in response. Swayler? Don't tell me. Blocks of iron have been severely weakened due to the entropic corrosion. Now, the stalactites are crumbling and falling from the ceiling, like heavy ballista bolts falling from the sky. As the chair is forced to submerge in the ground to avoid them, Antonina and I have to run and hide. Where the hell is she going? It's never moving away from us. She's trying to escape. Don't go out. Mind the falling rocks. She seems to be shouting something else. The sound of the falling rocks drowns it out and I can't make it out. After who knows how long, the tremor finally stops. We begin to emerge from between the rocks and meet up with Hachichiri. I'm glad you're both alright. Your target has vanished, but Toyo's signal is still nearby. I could sense Toyo's signal when she attacked the grotto ceiling just now. It's very likely she's above us. Above us? Indeed, the entropic signals look like they're far exceeded what we've been so far. It would seem that there's another space above this cavern. He might be trapped by the entropics and unable to free himself. But I keep sending a repeating message that things are very grim. What do you plan to do next? We intend to pursue the higher entropic we came here for. I see. In that case, our partnership is coming to an end for real this time. Sure. Alright. Maybe we meet again. But before that, perhaps... Goodbye then, Professor. But Cecilia takes my hand. After a quick shake, she dives back into the ruined ground and vanishes from sight. Strange. This makes no sense. Are you talking about a centurion of the higher order trumpet? Hey there. Go and take a look at this, Professor. This is... Oh, I look in the direction where Danita's pointing and see her rune machine parts taking it out from underneath the rune rock walls. At first, I wondered if it was an agent who accidentally stumbled in here if it was left behind by a sanctifier. But on close inspection, it looks like it was installed here from the beginning and damaged by an external attack. Can you determine its original purpose? That'd be very difficult. It's too badly damaged, ruined, and eroded. I need some time to perform a more detailed analysis. Man-made devices in a tropical layer. Very suspicious indeed. Also, Professor, don't you think this higher entropic is almost zero hostile intent? We wrecked a lot of entropicis along the way here. They were all composed of the most basic entropics surrounded by a somewhat higher order entropic. Despite being the highest order entropic here, she hardly had any subordinates around to protect her. You say that, but you're describing them as oceans and waves of entropics, like literal solid waves. Still, time is limited. All we can do is keep pursuing her. Yeah, we can't let her go. Croque and the others are still waiting for us. We need to get our source code ASAP. Damn it! She's flying all over the place! Persicaria? Going after her! Something's not right, so... Come back! Well... Okay! So, bisects the intrepid creature, charging up behind her with a swing of her sword, and jumps back to Persicaria's side. What's wrong, Percy? I think the pursuit was a little too successful. So, can you send me your combat logs? Let me sort out the terrain of info. There we go. Thanks. What I thought. What did you find? What else speed and loader in the lower order and Tropics blockade ought to be enough to shake us. But she seems to be trying to lure us somewhere. Oh, so it's a reverse dragon then. You're familiar with that. Let me take a look. You're dead on, Persicaria. I just analyzed pursuit route and her current terrain info. If you continue on the route we're going down, it's trying to lead us here. That's the direction of the ecological observation post. So you can say you still think that's wrong. I'm a little sweat drop. This is bad. Can't let her go then. The observation post. It's there. Ah, she climbed up again. That's just an automated response. Well, at least you verified the location. We can head out now. Let's head to the ecological observation post. But you can't let her go, can we? Why don't you go to the ecological observation post while I go after her first? If you're Percy and Fred, and Odile will run away, all we need to do is head to the observation post and intercept her. Yes, Mr. Lacey. Would you let me do some operants? You want to buy our operants? I'm sorry, we're just temporary partners asking you for operants. It's just rude. Well, that's not the problem. It's just I give operants just a little rough. Lacey's tail swishes around as she speaks. That's our friend. Now's not the time to quibble about such details. And allow me. Is an unexpected method. Do you really have to do this? You desperately need operands right now, don't you, Percy? Just bear with it, because here I come. Oh? I didn't think you could use your tail that way. That's a tall maintenance technician for you. After finishing their preparations, there's a car in there? Company rushed straight to the ecological observation post. This is it! Ahead of us should be... Oh, wait a minute. That's a dial! The black figure is floating in the air not too far from the observation post. He hovers above the ocean surface, flapping her roughly formed black wings. As she stares at the dolls with icy cold gaze, we meet again, the Dragon Slayer heroes. They seem to predict how the script would go. I'm talented. However, taking backseat ruins the experience. A proper audience should not deal with such things. Can't you talk like an oral person? Did you set the bedrock and cause the tsunami? The master needs a seatbed. Finding a new stage for her is our mission. All the necessary conditions are present here. That is all. I knew it! Nanaka has been infested by the entropy. That means Professor Antonina. You actually understood that, Percy? Where's the Prophet Anna? Did he meet them underground? They are most suitable stages for such rising stars and bright figures. More heart-rending tragedies await them. As for you, it is time to make for your exit. In an instant, the doll turns into a cold black streak diving straight for Sol. Sol immediately draws her longsword and wristly slashes forward. Blade and claw collide in a sharp clang. Huh! He's already got him getting entropized. Sol blocks a doll's attack with sheer force, halting her advance. As she maintains her grip on her sword, to adjust her posture that she can reach for the short sword on the right side of her waist. While Dal retreats, she can immediately draw the short sword and cut her open. If she continues maintaining her luck, she won't be able to avoid the other's attacks. You stepped into it this time! Battle was never a specialty of this body, and the master's modifications are not yet complete, which is why I have no intention of relying on brute strength before. In the next moment, undeveloped tentacles emerge from the doll's wings, spraying liquid entropy. Sol knows she can't block that in time, so he kicks the doll away and leans back to avoid the sprays of entropy. Even so, a few drops manage to make contact with the lower abdomen. A green glow envelops the air where the liquid entropy touches the skin almost instantly. A thin pair of operon neutralized entropy, which crumbles as a white operon particle falling off. Thanks, Percy! Careful! She's flipped to the sea! Having failed her attack, Odile is now hovering over the water again. She seems to be using the ocean as a natural barrier. Nobody present can move on water, which means you can't strike back at her. I can't reach her with my blades! Percy, can you attack from afar? I can't aim properly! She's too agile! Damn it. If I'd known, I should have had the Prophet sign me a cannon. Sally! She's coming in for another pass! Huh? Sol splashes the place where Adal is diving, but they both miss each other again. Stage combat is quite tedious. It's time to introduce some variation. Odo turns around midair and rushes at Persicaria, dividing Sol with a shield. Huh? Sol! Keep your eyes on me! I'm your opponent here! So it matters to get in front of Persicaria in time and deflects the doll's attack again. Persicaria, Deli, move up and back me up with the operants! And bring the dark administrator over too! Don't give her a chance to make another ambush. Pilot! The dork? Fighting wild dicks is my specialty. I can protect you at this range. We'll wear her down and look for an opening. Got it. Odile dives several more times, but Sol blocks her time since she'll attack repeatedly. However, contrary to expectations, Odile's movements do not grow slow over time. In fact, she seems to be gaining strength as she fights. In fact, it is Sol who first starts to show tire under the relentless assault. That's strange. He's been flapping around in the sky all the time. How is she not slowing down? Is she a monster? Okay, well, she is a monster. Where are you looking? Showing the audience your back is a rookie mistake in theater. Yeet! Oh, please. Have some like tension when dealing with the likes of you. A grand performance is about to begin. and you're both the audiences and the dancers. What a pain. We can't go on like this. Chihuahua-san! Ah, seriously? If only I could fly too. Fly. So, I've got an idea. Oh, it's Persicaria for you. Miss Lacey. Always happy to help. Huh? Why didn't you call Deli? Wait. Don't tell me you're gonna cheer. Rashid looks at two of them, pauses for a moment, and smiles knowingly. I got it. Get ready, Sully! No talking during the performance. Rel cannot, or perhaps she does not want to understand what is happening now. But after a round of attacks, with eyes that flaps her wings when she tires up the air out of caution. Now! Santa Deli! Okay! In the next moment, the Lacey turns 180 degrees and swings her tail, aiming at Sully. Whoa! The rubber cables wrap around Soshi. Once they secure her, the lady spins another revolution. The massive centrifuge of forks are sold to the ground until they're flying along a perfect curve for the end. As the soul reaches her terminal velocity, the lady's tail releases its clip. Sully, missile fire! You! Like a loose arrow, Soul shoots out and instantly catches up with Odara in the air. Odara tries to evade her, but one of her wings suddenly loses balance. Persicaria's half-straight attack is caught up with her right at this moment. Wire flu isn't exactly an easy thing. Thank you, Miss Odara. You. Searing Lion Flash! Corada! Soul's twin blade instantly ignite and cut down mercilessly towards the dial. A crescent of flames cut through the air, and the blazing edge of Soul's blades instantly ignite the feathers on the dial's wings. Soul makes a neat landing. At the same time, Odile crashes heavily into the ground without her wings disappointing. Brought you down at last! Well done. I approve of your performance. But this cannot end yet. The final stage is not yet prepared. Now, the masses dance. Minions will continue this dance. So, look out. She's directing all the intrepids around her to escape. To cover her escape. Get back here! You love it as Kodo Kaidisha? Anywho. Wait, hello? Okay, it's picking up normally. The underground fights are typically more scary. Chandra got destroyed. Not much you can do. I go back to the offensive build here. now we're a lot better. This is likely not a good idea. The other idea. Two, four, six, seven. These count as. He's doing less damage now. Okay, I should swap these two. The chances of flitting around everywhere. Yeah, I've just seen that maybe it's preferable. This one. The reflect probably makes that worth it. The jumbled is really helpful, but don't know. Eventually. How much does MKLO do? Not that much. Good, I guess. Let's sell. I think I will. Pressurization would have also been really good.
Go!
That took a while to get the perfect angle. Fire pressurization. Definitely don't need more vent zones. So let's start up here. He's definitely, or she's definitely not taunting. It's untargetable. As well. Let's start with this one. She's got to reflect.
Come
on. I had pressurization. That's That's a pretty good ulti. The 15, yeah, this thing. Incremental pursuit. Does all damage move there? Does anyone doesn't work on derivative? 1.4k. Boom! Oh, it's actually up to one shot it. Nice. The last hit.
みんなが努力した結果です。装備行動開始だ。
It's three layers, so I'll try to get that advanced zone if possible. Chauncey has so much more attack. I put a few foreign on her.
What?
Doing not bad.
撃退しました。
Knowing that eventually it sucks even more damage. Why couldn't you like this one? Okay, so if it does, if it doesn't count burn, it should be 3. I'm pretty sure burn is included. Yeah, because 3. Because it was supposed to end on 3. Yeah, burn is included. The burn is included in the damage. That's nice. Because now my bows are the linger. It's like, those are such good functions. I can always ult. And rather take this than nothing. Ooh, a pivot. A joyous day. Yeah, go this top path. Is that wasted? The battery and this one is really dumb. That is like 50,000. All the damage. Snug is so nice for consistency. Yes, please. I will take a free 40 crit damage or whatever that is. Undersold, from what I remember. Is there anything I can sell? Yes, this. An extra function slot. Maybe I should have just bought an extra function slot. Wait, want their sigils. Wait, that's how I can heal. That's how I heal with them here. They just book their sigils, though. That's the same path. Might as well find out what it asks you tomorrow. I'd rather not get silent rage, please. That's no skills. Same stuff in there.
Glass lens and adjustment complete.
Even if the enemy dodges, they'll still get hit by stack. I don't think there's like anything else I can really buy. So we should accomplish? But tomorrow I'll probably just burn all my stuff on Paradigm because lazy. Actually, if I get stronger, I could go to a weekend. reflection. A short train and one on a pretty bad time of day. But something to help me relax. Thank you so much for tuning in, Bingo Tingden. I'll see you next time.